Well, you might have heard recently by an ad or two, the election is just days away now, and on your ballot, you will also likely see some choices for judges in multiple different courts. But do you know exactly what each one does? In this week's Know the Law segment, Tom Sinas joining us to talk about the different court levels and why the vote is so important. Tom, this is interesting.
It is. And, you know, and we've talked over the years about how our court system worked, and it occurred to me that as we're getting ready to go to the ballot box, we should maybe review that, because when you get in the ballot box, you see all these judges and these different courts, and it's kind of hard to remember, well, who am I voting for and what?
Because we don't hear a lot about them compared to the other races.
Exactly. So a basic pointer is that we have really three levels of courts in Michigan.
Okay.
We have our trial court level, and that is those are divided into what are called district courts and circuit courts.
Sure.
Okay. The circuit courts being the ones of the broadest jurisdiction. This is where matters go when they're litigated at the ground level.
Okay.
Then we have what's called the Court of Appeals.
Sure.
Right? That's the first level of appeal, and everyone has a right to an appeal to the Court of Appeals. The third level is the Michigan Supreme Court. That's our highest appellate court. They only hear cases that they choose to hear.
Sure.
All right. So what's happening around this part of the state when it comes to judicial elections? Well, in Kent County, we have two open seats on our circuit court.
Okay.
Again, the circuit court is the trial court for significant civil cases, and it's also where felony cases go to trial. And they're very, very busy dockets. And those judges not only handle civil and criminal, but some of them do family law and they do probate work. Okay, so we have two open seats created by the retirement of two circuit court judges, and there are four people running for those two open seats.
Okay.
The Supreme Court. Now, this is very interesting. We have six candidates running for two seats on the Supreme Court. Two of the people currently incumbents are incumbents because they were appointed by the governor. But no one in this particular group of six has actually ever been elected to the Supreme Court.
Interesting.
Okay, so there's two incumbents, and they have an incumbent designation because they've been appointed by the governor.
Okay.
And those two incumbents are now facing their first election.
Sure.
And there are other people who are challenging them for the Supreme Court race. And so there's six candidates, two spots. The top two vote getters will get those two seats on the Supreme Court. The rest of the Supreme Court justices are not up for re-election other than the two that are designated on the ballot.
Okay. If we like maybe wanted to, real quickly, want to do some research on these people, how do we, you know, how do I pick? How do you learn who to pick?
I would recommend that you go and look at the ballot, your ballot, and see who's going to be on there. The Supreme Court, of course, will be the same for the whole state.
Mm-hmm.
And then do some research on the candidates.
Okay.
There's a lot of information out there, but it's obviously hard to do when you get in the ballot box.
Sure.
So take a little bit of time. These are really important races. I think we all forget, and part of the reason we do this segment is because the law affects all of our lives.
For sure. Real quick, people have questions. Where do they find you?
They can find us online at www.sinasdramis.com. Give us a call in West Michigan at 616-301-3333. Or shoot us an email at info@sinasdramis.com.
All right, thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Derek.